right. This is the demonstration note for the linear regression. So it's inside your model. The note talk about the, you know, some basic things about regression, including, you know, what we expect from you and the data that we are going to model, the outcome and predictive variables, the workflow and the framework that you need to understand and follow at all time. And then we run the linear regression model, you know, for the analysis, and present the linear regression results and maybe some homeworks that you can do on your own, optional, just to make sure that you are on track. So so we have a data on Toyota Corolla, okay? Toyota Corolla cars. So we have two data set, which one is in .csv and the other one is .xlsx. Okay. Why I've got two, just to you know, as a practice to read one CSV file and the other one is Excel file. And remember that in data has observations, rows, and variables in columns. The variable that we want to explain is price, okay? Price of the Toyota Corolla car. So we have this predictor that we think could explain our price, okay? One is age, mileage of the car, fuel type of the car, horsepower, whether the car has metallic or non-metallic color, whether it is automatic or not, CC, the CC of the car, the doors, weight, engine, cylinder, and so on and so forth. If you look at your at the data, you'll notice that the fuel type predictor has three categories, okay? Petrol, diesel, and CNG. When you have this kind of variable, the categorical variable, one of this group will become the baseline group, okay? Will become the baseline group. Metallic colors has two categories, yes, no. It was coded as 0 and 1, but it is not number actually, okay? 0 represents no metallic color, or not metallic color, and 1 represent yes, it's a metallic color car. So always think of this workflow if you want to analyze your data. And for the framework, refer to a lecture on regression prediction. And for this linear regression model, we will model based on these predictors, okay? So we think that price could be explained by age of the car, mileage of the car, weight of the car, fuel type, and metallic color. So this is how we write our model. Some math notations, okay? So what the expected value of price equals the intercept plus the beta value times variable age plus beta value times mileage plus beta value times weight plus beta value times diesel plus beta value time petrol plus beta value times metallic. And if you will see here, there is no CNG, right? Because CNG becomes the baseline variable. And if you look here, metallic color, this metallic means yes, okay? Yes for metallic, and no will be the baseline group. So always start with a new RStudio project, file new project, new directory, and write a new name here so that, you know, a folder will be created. These are some of the different packages that I usually load when I want to analyze data, because they are useful for me most of the time. Tidyverse for data wrangling and plots, Broom to create nice outputs from a regression model, ReadR to read data, ReadExcel to read Excel file, CableXtra to make better tables, and Janitor to clean variable names. Sometimes variable names are messy. There are spaces and symbols and whatnot. So here, you read data. This is pipe, okay? P-I-P-E, pipe. This is how I read CSV data. This is how I read Excel data. This is trim white space. I don't want to have spaces between variable names, okay? And I want to clean the names. So now all names becomes, you know, small caps. I use a summary to return summary statistics of the data set. Glimpse to have a quick peek at the types of variables. Okay, there are so many variables, right? But, you know, based on our model, we think that, you know, age, km, fuel type, matte color, and weight are the variables that explain the price. Okay, why I keep ID, because ID is very important in your data. Okay, it is important because, you know, sometimes you need to go back to the original data, and without ID you don't know that row or that observation refers to which data. Prices, of course, is here because that's the variable that you want to, that's the variable of interest, okay? That's the outcome variable. So now, you know, you do select, you run select. Now contain only 7 variables. And if you look here, the metallic still coded as 1100. And you know that 0 means the car is not metallic, and 1, the car is metallic. So I want to convert that from DBL, not DLB, okay, from DBL to factor. So I use mutate, factor, and write label here, no and yes, okay. I put no first because it was, the number will start with 0 and 1, okay, 0 and 1. So 0 means no, and 1 means yes. If I put yes here and no here, then 0 here will be coded as yes, and 1 will be coded as no. So be careful when you use a factor. Then we do exploratory data analysis, do summary, then run this summarize function. Hopefully you still remember this, and use gather to, you know, to return these results. I also do data visualizations, a simple histogram, okay, a simple histogram here for variable age of cars. Most cars basically more than 60 months. Mileage, also histogram. Looks a little bit skewed to the right. Just a bit skewed to the right, okay? Weight. A bit skewed to the right, with some cars very heavy here, okay? Not too many. I use count here to look at the number or the frequencies of the cars for based on metallic color and fuel type. Then I use geombar for categorical variable. This is categorical variable. Okay, so I can get this bar chart. And then for linear regression, I use a function lm. Okay, lm. And this is the y variable or the outcome variable. And this is tilde, a symbol below your escape button. And then these are the predictors, okay? And you have plus sign. And then comma, and then which data? That Toyota 2 data, okay? So, and then I run summary. This will return as a summary of the linear regression result. And then I use tidy function from Broom package to get a cleaner, nicer, simpler results, okay? Which actually comes from here, okay? 196, 196, 122, 122, right? Then I use augment to generate the predicted and residual value. So this is the predicted value, okay? This is the fitted value. It means that if we know the age of the car, we know the kilometer, we know the fuel type, we know the metallic color, and we know the weight, we can predict the value of the car. So the actual value of the car is 13500. This is the actual value. But if you know the age of the car, which is 23 months, mileage of 46986, which is a diesel car, and is a metallic color car with weight of 1165, based on your model, the predicted or the fitted value of the price is 15990. It's above the observed price. So the difference between the two, this one and this one, the difference is called as residual, this one, right? So this one observed minus fitted, you got minus 2490. This one, the observed price is higher than the fitted price, so you got positive value. And then model assessment, I use geom point. So I for the x variable, I use dot fitted from here and dot residual from here. So I plot a residual plots. How do you feel about the plot? Not perfect, right? Not beautiful, because you got some points here which are lying quite further away. But overall, maybe it looks okay, right? Except for that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 observations. The rest looks okay. So you might want to accept this model. Not perfect, but might be acceptable. You can filter those variables that, you know, less than 7500, these three, and you can see that, you know, why they are very different. You know, the observed value is 12450, but the predicted value is 25895. Not sure why. Okay, the actual value is very much low. You can use your pen and ruler and get the information from here and write it down in the table. But you can use this the tidy cable and cable styling to make a nice output of the of the results. Okay. So so that's basically the flow of doing things. Okay, you know, read your data, wrangle, visualize, model, assess, and present. Okay. And remember, you need to interpret this model. Okay, you need to interpret the beta value, and the p value, and the confidence intervals. All right, confidence interval. So p value, usually people are interested in the cut point of 0.05. Anything less than that, it means that that variables are important to explain the outcome. If the variables or if the predictors are bigger than 0.05, then they are not that important. Okay. All right. So what I want to do is, you know, find data set, okay, and identify variable of interest, think about the predictors variable, and run your model, assess your model, look at the linearity, normality, equal variance, and also interpret. Okay, interpret a model. If you know how to present but you don't know how to interpret, then that is also a problem. Okay. All right, so thank you.